students, the problem given here is x into p plus y into q is equal to 0. Let this be taken as equation number 1. And look into the equation, x power 1 into p plus y power 1 into q is equal to 0. So from this you can decide what type of partial differential equation it is. So it is type number 5. Type number 5 is f of x power m into p comma y power n into q is equal to 0. Here m is equal to 1 and n is equal to 1. It is case 2. It is case 2. For case 2, put capital X is equal to log X. From that, from x. And you assume capital P is equal to dou z by dou capital X. Now you know that dou z by dou small x is equal to dou z by dou capital X into dou capital X by dou small x. And dou z by dou small x can be written as p. And dou z by dou small x is written as p, and at the right hand side dou z by dou capital X we have already taken as it is capital P, and dou capital X by dou small x it is 1 by x. You substitute small p is equal to capital P into 1 by x. So we have to find out a substitution for xp. You move this x to the left hand side, xp is equal to capital P. Now put capital Y is equal to log Y. And from that, dou capital Y divided by dou small y is equal to 1 by Y. And let you take capital Q is equal to dou z by dou capital Y. Now we can write dou z by dou small y is equal to dou z by dou capital Y into dou capital Y divided by dou small y. And you have to look into this equation. When you cancel dou capital Y and dou capital Y, it will become dou z by dou small y, which is equal to the left hand side. Now you substitute dou z by dou small y. Dou z by dou small y is equal to q. Dou z by dou capital Y, it is capital Q. And dou capital Y by dou small y, it is 1 by y. From this, we can get yq is equal to capital Q. And xp, let this taken as equation number 2. And let this taken as number 3. And you substitute for xp and yq. Substitute 2 and 3 in 1. P plus Q is equal to 0. Substituting 2 and 3 in 1, we get the capital P plus capital Q is equal to 0. This is type number 1, which is F of small p comma Q is equal to 0. And for this type of equation, let the solution be, how we have taken the solution? Let the solution be for f of p comma q is equal to c is equal to a into capital X plus b into capital Y plus c. And as usual procedure, let you find out capital P, which is equal to dou z by dou capital X, which is equal to A, and capital Q is equal to dou capital Y divided by dou Y, which is equal to B. Substitute 6 in 5, we get a plus b is equal to 0. From this we should get b is equal to minus a. Our purpose here is to find out a substitution for B in terms of A. Now the equation number 4. The solution, equation number 4, will become z is equal to ax minus ay plus c. Now substituting for capital X, z is equal to a into log x minus a into log y plus c. This is the complete integral. For this type, there is no singular integral. Now you have to look into the problem. The problem is xp into y cube and x power 1 into p, y power 1 into cube. And this is of the type f of x power m into p comma y power n into q is equal to 0. Here m is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. So we have to approach as per case number 2, and we have to find out a substitution for xp and yq in terms of capital P and capital Q. And if you find out the substitutions for xp and yq, you can get type of equation, and from that type you have to arrive the solution as usual procedure. Students, the problem given here is solve x squared into p squared plus y squared into q squared is equal to z squared. Let you take this equation as number 1. You rewrite the equation, xp the whole square plus yq the whole square is equal to z squared. Why we are writing this equation as xp the whole square plus yq the whole square is, so we have to find out whether this equation belongs to type number 5. X is there, y is there, and z is there, and in the type number 5 it may belong to the equation number 2. So in the type number 5, f of z comma x power m into p comma y power n into q is equal to 0, and you look into the rewritten given equation, x power 1 into p, y power 1 into q is equal to z squared. So z has come, x power m into p has come, y power n into q has come. Here m is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. So this is the type f of z comma x power m into p comma y power n into q is equal to 0. Here we find that m is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. So it is to be solved as case number 2. In the case number 2, we will be taking capital X is equal to log X and differentiating capital X with respect to small x, and dou capital X by dou small x is equal to 1 by x, and we shall also take capital P is equal to dou z by dou capital X. And for small p, we can write dou z by dou x is equal to dou z by dou capital X by dou small x. And at the left hand side, dou z by dou small x can be written as small p. At the right hand side, dou z by dou x we have taken as capital P. And dou capital X by dou small x we have arrived as 1 by x. So it is P into capital P into 1 by x. Therefore, we have to find out the equivalent for xp in the given equation. So xp is equal to capital P. Similarly, put capital Y is equal to log small y, and differentiating capital Y with respect to small y partially, we get dou capital Y divided by dou small y is equal to 1 by y. And let you take capital Q is equal to dou z by dou capital Y. And dou z by dou small y can be written as dou z by dou capital Y into dou capital Y by dou small y. And dou z by dou small y is equal to Q. At the right hand side, dou z by dou capital Y we have taken as capital Q. And dou capital Y divided by dou small y, it is 1 by y. Our purpose is to find out an equivalent term for y into q in the given equation. So y into q is equal to capital Q. Students, you have to be very careful. You should not slip in any step. Now, we are having equation number 2 and equation number 3. Now substitute 2 and 3 in 1. Substituting 2 and 3 in 1, we get capital P squared, because 2 is xp is equal to capital P. Capital P squared plus Q squared is equal to Z squared. Let you take this as equation number 4 and look into this. Capital P squared plus Q squared is equal to Z squared. P is there, Q is there, Z is there, and this is of the type f of Z comma P comma Q is equal to 0. Here you should not forget that capital P and capital Q has been taken. You should not confuse with the model, but here we have assumed capital P and capital Q. And for this type number 3, that is f of z comma p comma q, that is type 3 first order partial differential equation, let the solution be z is equal to f of capital X plus cap plus a capital Y. Here you should remember that f of x plus a y is x and y are capital letters. F of x plus a y be the solution of 4. And as a usual procedure, we will assume that u is equal to x plus a y, and from that v x is equal to 1, and dou u by dou capital Y to a, and we have to write capital P is equal to dou z by dou capital X, which is equal to d z by du into dou u by dou capital X, and dou u by dou capital X is 1, and this equation is reduced to dz by du, and to dou z by dou capital Y, which is equal to dz by du into dou u by dou Y, which is equal to a into d. And here you have to go for one step further. Z is equal to a function of u. From that we have written capital P and capital Q. Substitute 5 in 4. You are getting, now you look into the equation number 4, it is P squared. For P squared we are substituting dz by du the whole squared, and Q squared a squared into dz by du the whole squared. Dz by du the whole squared is commonly taken outside, so it will become dz by du the whole squared into 1 plus a squared is equal to z squared. And you should be careful in the substitution. Now du the whole squared into 1 plus a squared is equal to z squared is has been rewritten here. Now, taking square root on both sides, dz by du at the left hand side is equal to 1 plus a squared is taken to the right hand side, it will become square root of 1 plus a squared because we are taking square root on both the sides, and z squared will become z, and keeping dz on the left hand side, moving z to the left hand side, it will become dz by z, and moving du to the right hand side, it is du by square root of 1 plus a squared, and taking integral on both sides, integral of dz by z is equal to 1 by square root of 1 plus a squared into integral of du. Integral of 1 by z dz is equal to log z. At the right hand side, integrating du, we will get u divided by 1 plus a squared, plus b is the arbitrary constant here. Therefore, log z is equal to, you substitute for u, u has already taken as capital X plus a into capital Y divided by square root of 1 plus a squared plus b. Therefore, log z is equal to, we have assumed capital X is equal to log small x and capital Y is equal to log small y, and right hand side it is log x plus a log y divided by square root of 1 plus a squared plus b. Now you have to look into the equation why we should not slip in writing capital X and capital Y, because capital X has already been assumed as log small x, capital Y has already been assumed as log small y, and if you slip in these steps, and definitely the problem is going to be a mistake, and this is the complete integral. For this type there is no singular integral.